So I drew what I had from the Central Trust, and I bought us two tickets on that Coast City bus. Now, baby, everything dies, honey, that's a fact. But maybe everything that dies someday comes back. Put your makeup on.
I didn't really think politically at all, really, about Nebraska at all until I think I'd read it in a review someplace that someone mentioned the record had a variety of political implications. And at the time, that was my most personal record. I felt it was a record that felt most like my childhood, you know. It was a record that reminded me of the way my childhood felt. Just in the tone of it, the colors that it had on it, just the house that I grew up in. I think that in my own life I had reached a point where I was old enough now to realize what was missing. And so I felt like I was teetering on this sort of void very often. And I felt a deep, deep sense of isolation and very difficult to get in, and it became very, very intense around that time. And I think that led me to those characters and to those kinds of stories. And I think when you get older, the price for not sorting through the issues that make up your emotional life and the choices you're making doesn't stay the same. Gets higher all the time. It gets higher from the same answers and the tricks and the lies you told yourself at 22. It feels pretty good. Hey, I'm just going on down the road, you know, 25, 26, 28. I feel a little less comfortable, but everything's okay, you know. The older you get, the price goes up. The price goes up, and it keeps getting higher and higher and higher, and you pay more on a daily basis for not coming to grips with some of those things. And at that point, I felt like I was at a place where I could start to really feel that price, you know. And I just felt too disconnected.
Born down in the dead man's town. First kick I took was when I hit the ground. You end up like a dog that's been beat too much. You spend half your life just to cover it up. I was born in the USA. Born in the USA.
The late 70s, early 80s was the first time when there was a literature and films began to be made about Vietnam. It really was. It was a subtext on a few earlier things. There was a movie called Who'll Stop the Rain that Nolte was in, and it was in and around a few things, you know, but all of a sudden it began to become very directly addressed.
Got in a little hometown jam, so they put a rifle in my hands. Sent me off to a foreign land, go and kill the yellow.
You know, I did the draft Dodger rag there at the time, you know. But that's all. I was 19. My drummer had gone and died. The best I remember, this fellow Walter Shoshone was the best front man in Central New Jersey at the time, and he joined the Marines, and he was MIA. And just on the street at the time, hey, people were frightened and everybody was trying to figure out how to get out, you know?
I come back home to the refinery. Iron Man says, son, if it was up to me. Went down to see my VA man. He said, son, don't you understand?
I didn't come out of a political household, you know. you were a part of, I was a part of, I suppose, what would be considered a counter culture at the time, though probably I was the conservative part, you know. I was, you know, I never had any real drug experience or I lived in a little town, I lived in a small town, you know, and there were lines drawn everywhere. I had a brother at Khe Sanh, fighting off the Viet Cong. They're still there, he's all gone. He had a woman he loved in Saigon. I got a picture of him in the room. I think that what led me to write about it was it seemed like whether you were there or whether you were at home in the United States, it was a defining moment in American culture in some fashion. It was a real, things really changed. You know, you felt things really changed. There was before and there was after, and the world and the United States felt like a different place. You know, I think that's what led me to write about it. It just felt central in some fashion. And it's sort of, it finds its way at this point, time and again, up through some of my songs, whether it was even on the Galveston Bay, it's at the edges in some fashion of a lot of experience. And whether you went or you didn't at the time, it was a big part of your life, you know.
Down the shadow of the penitentiary, up by the gas fires of the refinery. 10 years burning down the road.
I think that the recorded version had two things going. One was there was a lyrical content, which is a story of someone returning home and trying to find where they belong, if they belong. And then there was a sense of the music, which was sort of martial and powerful, and it was expressing a survivor instinct that I've been through this, and I'm out the other side, you know? And basically it was just, I'm alive. I mean, I feel like the record is right on the money, you know? There may be some misinterpretations of it out there, you know, but it was the right record.